You guys, there's a viral video that has been released of this woman who just needs a hug. She's lost her damn mind. So she was in Michael's, and she wanted a bag, but she didn't want to have to pay for the bag to put her items in.
Right.
And her items were too large to fit in the bag that she wanted. So the cashier asked if she could pay for a bag that would fit her item, and she freaked out. You guys, just look at the clip.
I'm going to give me a psychology lesson. You are not going to tell me who I can vote for and who I can't vote for. Yeah, you did. You voted for Trump.
You announced that to the store.
Yes, you did. And then you mumbled about who I voted for.
No, actually, I
didn't.
Yes, you did, and I was standing right there.
No,
and
she didn't.
I was
didn't.
Standing right there. Oh, was it you?
No.
It wasn't you.
So, at the beginning of the video, it's a lot.
Yeah.
Like I said, girlfriend needs a hug.
Yeah, I think that honestly is like the truest thing about this video.
Yeah.
Is we were just talking about this, whenever somebody goes off on something like that, their perceived lack of self-worth that someone else is seeing in them, anytime someone's screaming at you about like the good job that they have or how like go home to your like husband who cheats or any horrible petty things you say, it's because you have some huge hole inside yourself that has been triggered really hard.
Just bottled up too much emotion and it all came out.
This all got brought back to the election and I feel like she feels guilty for voting for Trump because I feel like she lives in a place that a lot of people maybe shame other people for voting for Trump.
She's
so I feel like that weighed heavy on her conscience.
Mm-hmm.
And it was an incidence of both parties having a bad day. The cashier's father had passed away. This girl clearly had Trump on her conscience and a few other things. And they both
I think that's very generous.
Because I don't think she was guilty of voting for Trump. I think she really stood for her beliefs.
Yeah,
I think
she definitely,
and I think it just shows that, I mean, I don't want to make any assumptions, but by what she was saying and the amount of time she brought up African-American, the African-Americans, the black people, like she was definitely feeling some type of way. The whole Trump thing
was
random.
The woman who's filming the video, she says to her, she goes, I'm being discriminated against by two black women.
Right.
You're a white woman. Yep. How could you, you know, like instantly you should be taking sides along race lines.
Yeah. Right.
There's no way you can act like there's not some racist undertone of what she's
doing. Oh, there's definitely racist undertone, but I'm...
Oh, I was gonna say about the Trump thing, about the guilt to Trump thing. I don't think that's, I think that a lot of Trump voters have been appealed to based on a kind of false victimhood that says like, you white people are getting victimized. Your lifestyle's being taken away from you, being encroached upon by people of color and immigrants and blah, blah. So she's there in this, I mean, I lived where she lives, like the north side of Chicago.
And you said there's a lot of
It's a lot of that privilege, a lot of that like that, you know, that Ugg and puffy coat and like bubble life, like privilege that's terrified of anything different from you.
Yeah. Mm-hmm. I just think it's crazy that she was like, I'm being discriminated against. How?
Yeah.
Well,
how?
I'm not supporting her. I think this girl has gone nuts. I would use cuss words, but we're not allowed to on the show, just so everyone knows.
Yes. And bless you for being a voice of reason here, because I'm going crazy.
No. And I understand that, but I feel... No, I don't know how to defend her. I tried. Sorry.
I mean...
No, I think the defense that you made is the truest defense. She's clearly so hurt and angry about something, probably a million things. We don't know what her family life is like. We don't know how she grew up or like how she's been emotionally manipulated by her parents or whatever. That like these things come screaming out.
For anyone to act like that in public, though, something is wrong.
Well, there's another video of her.
Issue.
There's another video of her screaming at a barista at a Pete's Coffee in Boys Town in Chicago, a gay barista, and saying that like also crazy like bigoted stuff, like being like, "Don't call me a bitch," and stuff. Like it's she's just
And I think that's proof. Like initially, when people are watching, like, okay, well, we don't exactly see what happened, what the interaction was. But for me, when I saw her go up to that other woman and just go off on her child, like, your child's stealing that.
And your husband's cheating.
And your husband's cheating on you.
Those are personal digs that were unnecessary.
Right when she did that, I was like, okay, their interaction probably was exactly what the ongoers were seeing was true.
Right.
You know,
because
when she started going off on all those other people, I'm like, all right, like clearly she's.
You know, a little off a rocker. And
as
much as I don't agree with anything she did and as much as I would never want to associate myself with someone like that, I think you guys are right. We do have to acknowledge the fact that something must be going on in her life that is
absolutely.
Just, like, that it just bottled up and it all just came out all at one moment, you know?
I think a lot of people who did vote for Trump, they feel this some type of way about the rest of the world, obviously. Mm-hmm. But I do feel like people that voted for Trump feel attacked by people that didn't vote for Trump, because say you go, oh, I agree with one of Trump's viewpoints, the full room of people that you're in automatically defriend you from Facebook,
right.
They alienate you, they call you mm-hmm. names, they say all of these things, and if that's happening to her 24/7, she's going to lash out in some way, which is sad because this is just dividing America even more. Do you know
but
what I'm saying?
Listen, but she pretty much, with her responses, is why people are mad about
right.
it. She called
yeah.
them animals, first yeah. off.
Multiple times.
Which is
multiple
a lot of coded language. A
exactly.
lot of coded
and
language
that's used
stuff.
A lot to describe African-Americans.
Right.
People say, oh, they're animals, they mm-hmm. don't know how to act right. And the fact that she used that word.
It's a demeaning term.
Well,
right.
this all started over a $1 bag. This girl didn't want to buy a bag. So if you don't want to buy a bag, well,
and,
carry
and
your
that
item
immediately
or
enters
don't.
Some like classist thing in her mind, too, or, like, which is like, either, like, she's like, oh, you think I can't afford a $1 bag, which instantly triggers some kind of, like, I'm better than you
exactly.
thing, and how dare you.
But everyone has to pay the $1 for the bag. It's not like they're
yeah.
so, like, being like, you have to pay $1.
Right.
Yeah.
So that girl, I feel like it's become a thing where you have to pay for bags. If
yeah.
you don't want to pay for the bag, say, hey, I'm going to carry that item, or suck it up and pay the dollar,
yeah.
because that's the reality of the situation. And then I guess the cashier next to her must have been like, she voted for Trump, or she mentioned that she voted for Trump, and everything
thing escalated.
That's what she started screaming.
Also,
yeah.
She's clearly like in fight or flight mode at this point,
right.
where she's just like, and some, you know, if you get caught in something unreasonable, because when she's calling the police, like, what are you gonna tell the police? I don't like that they shouted at me down the aisle and they said I had to pay for a $1 bag.
That's like, what she was saying, and you yeah. can almost tell the way she was responding to them that they were probably like,
well,
I think they almost hung up on her.
Yeah.
It seems like for a second they
multiple
hung up on her.
She was
saying, yes,
she was pissed because the manager didn't get mad at the employee
for
the way that the employee had treated her,
right.
which was telling her that
right.
she had to buy a $1
well,
bag.
Anybody who still right. thinks like the customer is always right is completely wrong. Like,
oh,
we live in
yeah.
a world now where it's like, we are not your servants.
Exactly.
We are all human
right.
beings who have jobs. But like, to me, what's crazy and also understandable, very human, is like, if you get caught in something unreasonable, you're already angry, you're a little embarrassed, you just double down on it.
Yeah.
You just get crazier and louder.
Yeah. Yeah.
Right now, in today's age where social media is all the rage, I don't know if somebody pulls out, I guess she's like thriving off of the energy of people filming her and this possibly going viral. But for me, if I was going nuts and people started filming me, I would take a step back and think, what am I doing?
Go ahead, please. I honestly think the filming thing just enraged her more because
yeah.
when she saw the people with the cameras, she was like, oh, well, let me film you. How do you like it? Like,
yeah.
And I think that just
I guess she
into her
felt like everyone was supporting the store who she felt were
against her.
Yeah, against
yeah.
her.
Well, it also, it doubles, it is exemplary of this whole Trump, like, rhetorical phenomenon,
mm-hmm.
too, where, like, you do something that everybody laughs at or you should be embarrassed about because you said something wrong or you flat out lied or you're creating a situation totally emotionally based on nothing in reality.
Right.
And you just keep going with it. And when everybody films you and says, like, you should take a look at yourself, when you see it, instead of living in reality and going like, yeah, it was a little bit, you go, no, that's good. That's how I was feeling. I don't know what I should be embarrassed about because I was being wronged.
Right.
You know what I mean? It's this whole, like, we're entering this strange time as a culture where, like, you can pick what reality you want to live in,
that's
which
true.
Facts you believe are true, which
scary.
News articles you think are true.
Yeah.
You know?
I think the coolest thing that happened out of this whole situation, though, is that the woman that was filming the whole thing, her name is Jessie, she actually started a GoFundMe page for the
yeah.
employee and was like, hey, this is what happened, and I just want to cheer up our holiday, and actually raised, right now, today, $32,000.
That's unbelievable.
And when they interviewed the employee, she was basically, all she said was like, I just hope, they were asking, what do you want for this girl that yelled at you? Like,
mm-hmm.
if you could say one thing to her, what would it be? And she was just like, I just want her to be okay, I just want her to know love.
To get help.
Yeah.
To get a hug.
To get a hug.
Somebody that loves her.
Yeah.
I want to know what went wrong in her life in general, because she seems like a put-together person. She was dressed like she has money and she might be educated. I just feel like I don't know what kind of, I mean, I guess you said you know many people that are.
Well, there's this thing they say influenza, which has become it's like a bit of a joke. But there is some truth, I think, that in bubbled communities, people who like are raised with wealth often just because you know how to make money doesn't know how you mean you know how to like operate emotionally well
right,
in the universe
right,
with
right.
empathy or kindness to even your children. Mm-hmm. You know, there's mm-hmm. like if you think about it, drug problems, discipline problems, like running into with a law that exists in wealthy communities mm-hmm. that don't exist in poor ones. Mm-hmm. It's because of this thing. You have a weird. I think this and it's easy to say like, oh, the poor little rich girl, you know.
Right.
But. On one hand, I think you see that a lot in the halls of power. Like these people who are, right. like the Trumps are all like that. If you're yeah. raised with money and crazy, suddenly you're out in the world actually making a huge impact on millions of other people yeah. because you are a captain of industry.
But that doesn't mean you know.
You know,
and
it's scary.
Exactly that, that's scary. Like you see someone, you're like, oh, they're put together, they're dressed well, but it's those people, just like her, who feel like they're entitled and like look put together, but they're
and also that kind of thing yeah. is so scary, like, this thing that's happening with the Nazis that are becoming popular, the mm-hmm. alt-right or whatever, and they just keep going like, oh, he's so dapper. They're so well put together. Mm-hmm. It's like a very bizarre, like...
Have you seen The Purge? Yeah. All of them are put together.
Yeah.
Like, the rich people with, like, you know...
Fucking, like Hugo Boss or something designed all the Nazis' actual uniforms. You know what I mean? They look very good, guys. Like, you say what you will,
that's
but
creepy.
They're very fashionable.
It's a little
you
creepy.
Know, but it is creepy, but it's like, this is crazy. The thing. We go like, she looks so put together. Why is
right.
she so crazy?
Right.
You know? And they look like animals.
I also...
You know?
Yeah.
It's like coded language stuff.
I can't imagine what was happening in the comments section because it has been disabled. The video has almost 4 million views, mm-hmm. and
yeah.
Whoever uploaded the video updated the description, and they were saying, I don't want to spread hate, that's why I disabled the comment section. I just hope that people can find the light. And they were like, this girl isn't even the problem. There's a much bigger problem than just her.
I think the lesson to be learned too, or a great example, is the way that the employee responded, because I feel like so many times when people are coming at you like that with racial slurs or just anger in general, mm-hmm. like we want to defend ourselves and
right.
we want to like fight back, but I think the employee did a really good job by just being very calm,
right.
Mm-hmm. responding yeah. with kindness, and I think a lot more people need to respond in that way, because
yeah.
that's what wins in the end.
I think that's a good way to respond to it, because it goes against what that woman is projecting onto you.
Right.
You know, it's like she's expecting her to be an animal and loud, whatever, and she's not.
Absolutely. Everybody's agreeing, I think, like, these people do just need hugs. You do need to respond to hate with love universally. Like, that's the correct answer.
Mm-hmm.
I think what's scary about where we're at is, like, if you're a reasonable, generally progressive-minded person, that is your approach. Is you're like, it's not a big problem, it's a little one. Like, what is the little lack in you that's leading to this horrible, you know,
right.
policy
mm-hmm.
that you're trying to enact? What I think is scary is how far do we let that go with people saying, bless your heart, while, you know, stabbing you in the back.
Right.
While, like, enacting actual policies that will, like, take away people's rights or harm them, and how long can we continue to be like responding with love and kindness and let's have a dialogue
right.
when they are marching as hard as they can towards actual laws
yeah.
that will affect people negatively.
Mm.
It's scary.
Yeah.
Sorry.
That was to like the whole situation.
We need to take a breath. We need to go to yoga. We need to love people. Hey, you guys, let us know what you think in the comment section below. I know you've probably seen this video. If you haven't, go watch it in full right after you finish watching this. Thanks for watching our show, and you can continue doing so over to the left. You can watch all the girls chat about the Gilmore Girls reboot, or click over to the right to see a Netflix tax that is putting an end to binge watching. Thank you.